Whoa. Ow. Just got shot. Never touch that ever again, okay? Never touch that ever again. Whoa, spooky. I am functional. Did you power the generator? I guess we did. Aren't you? Hey. I am functional. I can walk. Quite happy that he can walk. So you made progress in this world, John. But that progress stops here. I believe you need a code to unlock a certain box. Well, the code no longer exists in this world. You understand what this means, John? Yeah. Good. Start looking. Fuck. Am I desktop? Is it on the game folder? DonkeyMan1Shot.txt. Oh. Dear. A message to you. I'm afraid I must make it brief. I've left you a journal. One of which is written in the language that Salga texts. You know on the... Okay. Read it and you'll know what to do. I have also for metal safe in the quarry to the east somewhere between the ocean and the lookout point. The code you need is 104858. I understand. Is you gonna tell me something else? Stop. I guess I should put this in the middle. Pop-ups are gonna appear there. I guess that was kind of like, oh, you're stupid. Let me explain to you how fucking stupid you are. Can I just fast travel to the quarry? Somewhere between the ocean and lookout point. Okay, so I guess somewhere between the ocean and the lookout point. Oh, I remember where it is. Some goddamn. Is it powered up? Powered up. Hello, small person. You're not much brighter than... You're not much bigger than I am. Welcome to the lookout point. Below us is the old quarry. The head engineer lives a little more to the east. The entrance to the old mines is further to the east. I see. Wait, hang on. Before I proceed, I want to check if the thing is good. Because there was someone that got lost in the mines. If I turn on the power, they should have returned. Shouldn't they? The light's gone now. Must have imagined it. Well, let's see the robot woman. Do you need for this or something? Okay, so she's just not gonna give a fuck. Fast, go fast, very fast. Yeah, fast. Alright, the box should be around here. I remember it, and it said 6 digits, and the little kid said, I don't know, and I tried 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it don't work. I didn't try 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Metal safe, seems like a slug with a 6-digit code. I don't remember seeing it, did you do it, John? Whoa, it worked. Wait, how did you know the code, John? I don't remember seeing one. Had some help. Really? From who? Don't worry about it. Okay. It's in the safe, Nico. Oh, right. Let's see. Ah, I found a gas mask. Also, there's this weird-looking book. Can't read it, though. Not that I can't read or anything, because I can. I just don't know what language this is. What is that? I'll wear it when I have to. You can buy those. You can buy those. Okay. Oh, I have a clover EXE on the... It's fucking weird. I have a lot of tabs open. Let me close this off. Let me... John? John, can you hear me? Yeah. Oh. Whew. What happened? Everything went pitch black for a second. I guess I'm only leaving the game when you go to bed then. I guess I don't want to subject you to that again. My bad. Whoops. Kinda tearing up a bit. It was spooky. Sorry. Fuck. Can't I just fucking, you know what, fucking fast travel. Cliffs. Docks. There I go. So I could go to the top of the world, yeah? I'm on top of the world, yeah? Should be fun with this mask on. No! I wanted to look at your face with it. It's a gas band. Whoa, bubble. This plant sure looks different. The water looks like jelly? It's form a bubble over the surface of the pond. Bludgeon it. Shit. Fill it. Fill the bottle with the stuff, John? It's too goopy to fit in the bottle opening. It's like that one time years ago I tried to put tomato chowder in a baby bottle. And then I got everywhere. On the table, on my clothes, on the baby, on the baby's clothes. The grown-ups thought it was hilarious. They took a bunch of pictures. And then they taught me how to use funnels. And then they also told me I shouldn't try to babysit until I'm older. Anyway, we should probably look for a funnel or something. Well? Good point. You're just looking at the sky is dark. And it is. Do you know when the sun will be back up? We're working on it. That is the pondering robot. It was built specifically to ponder. Nothing else, really. I guess you want me to fill the bottle with this gas, John? That ought to do it. Wait, what? Bottle of smoke. Okay. Initially, the amount of noxious fumes emitted by the narrow gas vents caught our team off guard. Thank goodness the medical team reacted as quickly as they did. Despite its failure, the first expedition did bring up some interesting observation about the barrens. We found that there's not one, but two such vent zones. With fumes being pumped out at such high concentration, it seems a miracle that the gas isn't spread anywhere else. Our biologists concluded that the phosphor shrimp in the crater pools are actively consuming the gas. The shrimp in the ocean also prevent the gas from wafting off into the glen. I've had my mouse over there the entire fucking time, I'm sorry. If that's the case, and we owe a lot to these little guys. They're like little things that eat up the gas and make it into oxygen. Low living air filtration units. That's why you should pet the fuck out of them. They're saving your life. And they're also extremely economic to maintain, I assume. That's why they have a fuck ton of them. Took the mask off, but I didn't finish watching this. Yeah, I was wondering. Okay, yeah, I'm done in here. Also, I should probably walk. I don't want it. Imagine if just this... On... If you sprint on block number 856C. You will drop the sun and it will explode and it will permeate not only your game, but the Windows file so that it will always give you a game over. I say this as I keep sprinting. Hey, what's up? Hello, do you need any help? I'm good, thanks. I mean, what can you do? Whoa. I can flex my eyes. Evacuation? I saw church notice? I can't believe this. First the sun dies, now I'm out of a job. It's a mechanical drawing. It's like a square. Robot is beyond repair. Scared of ladders. Scared of ladders? One zero. All right, that's useful. Ooh, infirmary. I thought it was just a health power up. 112. Oh, it's got like glowing neon signs. Hello, organic person who is alive. The infirmary is up ahead. Hello, person of organic makeup. Welcome to the infirmary. Scanning for injuries. Scan complete. Injuries detected? None. Treatment required? None. You're good to go. Thanks? Hello, person. Are you seeking admission into the infirmary? No? Oh, carry on then. It's a box of medical tools. Most of them are broken or rusted beyond use, but this plastic stick's range seems to be okay. What the fucking... Ooh, I can use it as a funnel for the thing, for the goopy. Plastic syringe. I guess plastic is very, what's the word I'm looking for? Still scared of ladders. It's a robot. You know, I never ran around so many robots before, John, or... any robots at all. I mean, I see them in cartoons and stuff, but I've never seen one in person. They're pretty neat, don't you think? Hey, Nico, do a robot, boys. What? Try talking like a robot. People, I'm a robot and I eat batteries instead of normal people food. That is not correct. Robots do not consume batteries in the same way people consume food. In fact, robots do not possess digestive systems. Some robots do not even have mouths. Oh, I kind of embarrassed you. John, you made me look silly. Hello. Hi. What are you doing up there? I'm stationed here. By yourself? Yes. Okay. This is 118. And then black. Oh, there's a little terminal here. Check in. Terminal does not respond. This is a problem. Some of the ink on this page is faded. Likely due to some sort of electrical or magnetic interference. I'm afraid this operation can no longer be sustained. If the servers continue to fail so much that maintenance cannot keep up the pace, Fortunately, it does not seem to be happening to robots, at least not at a significant rate. Time will tell. All these terminals do not boot. I'm not sure what to do now. Yeah, I guess that fucks up with your program a bit. Have I gotten here? I haven't. Got any shrimp. I remember being taught in school about how the water surrounding the forest stretch until the boundaries of space. But at some point, the prehistoric oceans receded, forming what is now the Barrens. I wonder where all that water went. Went to the air, of course, would have became angels. That's how water do. Parasol thing. There's a writing on this one too. It says Guardians of the Residential Area. Looks like they're evacuating the few tame robots we have here. Makes sense. No point in keeping them in the Barrens if all the people are already gone. I wonder if the engineer is going too. Oh, so that's the engineer. Women with pink hair. Apparently phase one of the evacuation ended prematurely. The big ship started malfunctioning only after a few round trips. They said it was due to something with squares? I'm not sure what they mean by that. Bummer. Looks like they won't be able to transport most of these surplus bots to the city at this rate. And we worked so hard on those. But I suppose the robots are busy enough with transporting people as is. I think it's going to be our turn soon. So, engineer woman is a tame robot, which means she has been... She's been shown things like chess and stuff, like human-like features, which is why she's also human-like in nature. That's, I guess taming is like some sort of expensive and also a thorough thing. And also, what is this? Oh, hello. What are you doing here? A living person such as yourself should have evacuated this place long time ago. Oh, but I just got here to this world. I mean, see, I have the sun. Oh, the Messiah. I do not know what to say. Reading you was not part of my programming. Have you spoken to Prophet Bot? I think so, yeah. Prophet Bot was built with the sole purpose of greeting you. Really? Yes. You cannot speak with anyone else, at least not with these. Oh, that's... I guess... disappointing. What are you built for, then? My purpose is to guard the settlement. Even though the residents have long gone, I must remain. Ah. Why though? I have not been tamed. Tamed? It was not worth the effort. By the way, some robots may start following you around this settlement as well. Do not be alarmed. It is their job to keep people safe. Stay safe. So yeah. Only with robots that are worth the effort, like engineers and something that really... big important roles are supposed to be tamed. See the snow on the ground. There's something weird about the robots who get sent to work near the gas fields. They appear to accumulate rust at a much slower rate than the others. The few who work directly with gas harvesting look practically new. Is that a result of the atmosphere, or am I just seeing things? I have a fucking weapon. I'm getting near him. I have a weapon. I'm not afraid to use it. This game, for as naive as it is, it's kind of spooky me a little. Oh, hi. Hello, person. Welcome to the old chemical processing plant. Most of the equipment is already being relocated. It's all boarded up. We got the right tool. Good thing I kept this crowbar. They didn't throw it away like any other would. What a workout. This pair of rubber gloves, they're a bit heavy. Oh, now I can touch stuff. Hello, person. The robot assembly and repair services have been discontinued at the Baron. If you have further inquiry, please contact the head engineer. This will be a page rip out of the book. Cannot overstate the importance of cleaning solvents in this environment. Here's a simple recipe using the alternative method discussed in the last chapter, utilizing the natural properties of blue phosphor. Acidic gas, blue phosphor. Oh! In a well-ventilated area, direct the gas into your container choice. Seal immediately. I need something to seal it with once I'm done putting it in. The solvent. So that means I need to go back to the goop place. But I'm gonna check this place out a bit. I feel like I cannot proceed further because it's gonna be like, oh, you need this. It's gonna be like, ouch, it hurts, and I don't want him to say this. Alright, so I just did a full loop around.